Hi friends! Today I'm here to announce the Summer Scare Readathon 2021. It's pretty self-explanatory, but the Summer Scare Readathon is a readathon that I host in the summer of scary books. I tend to do a lot of mid-grade spooky during this week, but I also have a couple of other books that I plan to read. This is not going to be a TBR video, there's just the announcement video. We'll talk about the TBR later. So this readathon will be running from June 21st through the 27th. It's just a way for me to get some extra spooky October love in the middle of summer. It alliterates, so we went with it. I have 9 challenges, so if you want to read 9 books, you can. If you want to read one book that fits all of the challenges, you can. You can read any amalgamation, any number of books, any whatever you want. If you want to only read 2 prompts, that's fine. It's all super fun. There's no group book. It's just read some spooky books with me in the middle of June. It makes me happy. So let's talk our challenges. The first is to read a book with orange on the cover. Spooky. Read a book with blood on the cover. Blood on the cover can be actual blood on the cover. The word blood on the cover also counts. So think about that. Next is a mid-grade spooky. That's because I'm reading all of the mid-grade and I highly recommend you do as well. I love mid-grade spooky. It is some of my favorite spooky to read, so prompting you all to read that. A book with a spooky word in the title. So this is, I think, a carryover from last year. I think we did this one as well, but really anything spooky. Ghost, witch, smoke, shadow, moon. I don't know. Spooky words. If it's spooky to you, spooky. Okay. Witches, a book that has witches in it. Read a book with witches. A queer main character, because it is Pride Month, so let's read a book with a queer MC. Makes sense. A book by a BIPOC author, so a bi Indigenous person of color. Read a book by a BIPOC author. It's not that complicated. Next challenge, under 200 pages. Read a book under 200 pages. Oh my gosh, so difficult. If you're reading a mid-grade spooky, it's under 200 pages, like, no doubt. So there's that. And then for those of you who are not into the mid-grade spooky, one of the prompts is to read a horror or a thriller novel. That's 9 challenges. It means you can read 9 books, which I have 9 books assigned. Whether those all happen or not, probably not, but I have 9 books assigned. And then I'm just gonna read whatever I can. I'll read the books that cover the most prompts in the beginning of the week and then move through. So, or at least that's my plan. It sounds good, right? We'll be reading a bunch of the mid-grade spooky, which are shorter. They're typically like 100 to 150 pages. So that helps me read 9 books for sure. I also have another series that I own that is witches, that is spooky, that's YA, that are pretty short, like under 300. So like I already have a TBR formed in my brain, but I'm not sharing it quite yet. Much like last year, I will be putting up a Instagram story thing for you to write in whatever books you're reading. So there will be one of those going up soon. If you don't already follow me on Instagram, you should. I post there sometimes. Mostly I do post some book reviews, but I post a lot of things about me and my life and what's going on, and also graphics for readathons and things. So all of that can be found there. So that is the very short announcement for the Summer Scare Readathon. I will be doing a read-in that week on Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, as I always do. It just happened to fall in my every other week of Fridays, so even if it hadn't, I would have done one anyway, but it does fall in the week. So we'll be doing a live read-in on the 25th, I believe is the date. Don't quote me on that, but yeah. Let me know in the comments below if you plan on participating, if you have a TBR put together in your brain, in your mind, if you're excited, if you have ideas for prompts we should use for next year, any of those things, comment section down below. That's what that's for. That is all I have for today. I post reading, writing, book, and planner related videos a couple of times a week. If you don't want to miss anything I have going in the future, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell down below. And until then, I will see you guys next time. Bye!